I almost hit my camera.
Holy shit.
So let's go into the topic of what affects your heart rate, right? So let's split it into two to simplify. You got something that slows down your heart rate and something that speeds up your heart rate. So for things that slow down your heart rate, well, of course, the more fit you are, the less your heart needs to work since your body's basically fit. There are certain types of medications that make your heart rate go down. For me, for instance, I take a beta blocker. Of course, there's also this thing, calcium something. It's actually a weaker form of a beta blocker, and it also lowers your heart rate. Well, you know, these types of drugs, you really need a real prescription, and you really need to have yourself checked up with your doctor, because the problem is, you know, the dosage is quite dangerous if you take too much, or even at times if you take too little. Also, what lowers your heart rate is sleep. And, well, of course, that's if you have a good sleep, not like you have a nightmare or something. Nightmare, your heart rate just goes... And also, of course, when you're resting. On the other hand, your heart rate also goes really high when you do things such as exercising. Or even when you lift weights and all of this, you know, there's so much strain in your body that your heart just needs to keep up with the strain. When you are too dehydrated, your blood becomes thick, and because of that, you know, the lack of the oxygen and everything, your heart needs to pump much faster. Also, well, of course, as you know, emotions. If you're depressed, you're anxious, or overly happy, overly sad, you know, you also have such a thing as stimulants. So stimulants like caffeine and cocaine, I guess you could say. Also, when you're pregnant, it also affects your heart rate. When you're sick, when you have an illness, well, you shouldn't technically worry if your heart rate goes up when you have a disease or when you're sick, especially when you have a flu. The reason is your heart needs to work more to make your body better. So knowing that your heart is beating more actually proves that your heart is doing its job making you better. Also, if you have insufficient sleep and recovery. So of course you need to ask yourself, when do you need to be concerned? Head sitting on my board! Anyway, so you need to ask yourself these things. Are there times when, you know, you just feel like, you know, you're super dizzy, like extremely dizzy at times? Do you get these palpitations, you know, or you get this feeling like your heart is beating stronger than normal? Sometimes it's the other way around. You feel like your pulse rate is too low. For me, for instance, at one point when I overexerted myself playing football, I started to vomit. I started to feel, you know, really dizzy, overly fatigued. You know, all of these are signs that you need to pay attention to, because who knows? There just might be something wrong with your heart, and if you don't act now, you know, it just might be too late. So now I'm gonna try lying down on my board. All right. It actually, shit. Woof. Anyway, this is better. Let's try it. Oh yeah. Oh, I can do it. It's not. No, it's not doable. I need to turn. Turn. I hurt my leg. Anyway, Aman here from Heart Limits. I hope you liked my video, and please, please do subscribe, hit that like button, and always be happy. Ah, my leg.